YouTube, what's going on? It's your boy Grant here, and I am back at y'all with another banger YouTube video. And man, today, as you can see by the title, as I can see by the thumbnail, I'll be showing all the best methods in order to get all your playmaking badges fast and simple. So man, yeah, today I'll be showing how to get the best playmaking badges, and I have the best methods for them. Y'all just gotta, you know, believe in me, man. But before we even start talking about it, first, I'm gonna need y'all to go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel and like the video. So if you haven't done that, go ahead and do it, and then we'll go ahead and get into it. Okay, so starting off, I want to show y'all the build that I have. He gets 32 playmaking badges in total, but in order for this method to be simple for y'all, I'm going to show y'all what y'all need. So first, we'll start with the takeovers. I suggest y'all to get double playmaking take, pick both of these team ratings boost and team takeover boost. So pick them two takeovers with the accelerator perk or the extender perk for your perks. So not only that, I will show y'all the badges. I'm on my passer badge setup right now, but these are the badges that I have. If you can get bullet passer on gold, I suggest y'all to have that on. Y'all can get dimer on bronze, have that on, and needle threader on silver, have that on. So those are the only playmaking badges that you really need. Okay, so not only that, even though I don't have the quarter length on 10 minutes, with 10 minutes on, I have 42 assists, but I would have about 50 if I had on 12 minutes. So not only that, but you want to put your quarter length on 12 minutes. So that is it for the setup right there. So now we're going to go ahead and get to the gameplay and show y'all these methods. Okay, so for the first method, this should be the simplest one because all you need with this method is screens. In order to do it, all you need is to call for a screen holding the L1 button. And as you let go, run to the side while the person setting the screen drives to the paint. You pass them the ball and they score easily. Now, depending on what type of passes you throw, this method may not work all the time. That's why I never throw alleys on this build or when I'm getting my playmaking badges, due to the fact that they don't catch it all the time, especially if they're not very athletic. So before you pass the ball to your teammate, make sure you know who you're passing it to. So if it's Zach LaVine, I'm most likely going to throw the alley. But if it's like a slow center, I'm not going to throw him the alley unless he's like very wide open. So now I will show y'all more clips of the first method that I just explained, and then we'll move on to the second method. Okay, so now we are at the second method of this video, and the second method is a driving kick method. This method is very simple. All you need to do is, instead of calling for a screen, just drive straight in the paint between two people, which leaves one person open when you drive. It may not work every time, but most of the time you have takeover, it usually works. Usually using this method is best when you have great three-point shooters on your team. So if you're on the Lakers, or sometimes you could say the Bulls, because as you can see, they're shooting good right now, this is the best method to use, and also for the Warriors too. So if you have great three-point shooters, then the driving kick method is best. So now that was it for the second method, which is the driving kick method. I'll show y'all some more clips for this method, and then we're gonna move on to the third one. Coming up third is the double team method. This method works best when you have team tape. So when you have team tape, you got to keep your eye open due to the fact that you're most likely going to get double team. So when you get double team, as soon as you do, look for the person that's open. And when they're open, they hit the shot and you get your assist. So that is about like the easiest method that I have for y'all, besides the next one that's about to come up, which is the last one. But yeah, I'll just go ahead and show y'all some clips of this method, and then we'll go ahead and get into the next one. So now for the last method, this method is the freestyle method. And this method, all you do is just pass the ball and like let the assist come to you, so you're not trying your hardest to get it. I recognize that this is like the easiest way for me to get it, because when I don't try, you know, like it's easier for me to do stuff. I don't know if that makes sense to y'all, but yeah. So that is the last method. I'll show y'all like just like a little few more clips of this method, and then we'll move on. Okay, so now that was it for all of the methods for how to get your playmaking badges faster. I had 42 assists, but that's how much I got from getting all those assists. It wasn't that much compared to how I got 30 assists on one of my other builds. It doesn't make sense to me, but that's just how it goes. So if y'all did enjoy the methods and they work for you, let me know in the comment section. If y'all need some shooting badge methods or defensive badge methods, I'll get y'all with that. But yeah, I'll see y'all next video. Go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe.